I have finally made it further down the Peloponnese than I have ever been before. I am in Kalamata. And if you've heard of Kalamata and you're thinking, why do I know that? And that is because they are famous for their olives. However, there's so much more to see in Kalamata and around Kalamata. And I am here now at one of the big churches, Ipipanti Church. And around in this area is the historical center. Give you a little bit of perspective, this is where we're at. It looks like this church sits up on a little bit of a hill in Kalamata, but I thought it was a good place for me to start and then kind of walk down. Some of you may be wondering what I'm doing in Kalamata. I mean, not that I don't travel a lot, but I do have a purpose. I'm here for a travel bloggers conference, and tonight is the opening party. And that's part of the reason why I don't have a lot of time to explore Kalamata, because I'm gonna be in a conference for a couple of days. But we're having a party down in one of the main squares here tonight. So I wanted to come down and obviously explore before that. Look at this amazing fountain. That's nice. So gonna hit a few of the sites and then hopefully come down here tomorrow and see a few more things as well. Even those of you who don't like street art have to like this if you're a fan of Greece. This is a mural of all of the major players in the War of Independence in 1821. And if I recognize their faces better, I could tell you who is who, but I'm not that well versed yet. But it does say that it was commissioned by the Demos, probably for the 200th anniversary. And it is by a famous Greek street artist, Schizophrenus. I have seen his art everywhere, even in Naxos. This is one of the most amazing realistic ones I've seen. Right next to the street art is this church. This is the Church of the Apostles, I believe. I think she said it was Agios Apostolos. The lady at my hotel told me to come here. It is a Byzantine era church, and it is amazing outside, and it looks like the door is open, so let's go inside. I did not film inside because people were in there praying and it's tiny, so it would have been super intrusive, but it is very interesting on the inside. It has very interesting architecture, and it is even smaller inside than it is outside, but I definitely recommend that you go in. Really great plaque explaining everything about it. It is the Church of the Holy Apostles, not Apostolos, I had that wrong. It is where the Greek War of Independence was declared. And as you can see in this photo here, it was pretty well destroyed by that earthquake. And they have done a lot of work getting it back to its original condition. So good on them. And considering the earthquake was only, I hate to say this, 40 years ago, almost 40 years ago, that's pretty impressive. Much to my excitement, the archaeological museum is open. I thought that it was not open on Tuesdays, and I clearly read that wrong. And it's open till 8, so I have plenty of time to go inside before I have to go to this party. Probably will not be able to video, so I will show you photos of the things that I think are important, and then the rest you'll have to come discover yourself. Archaeological museum, and just the right size in my opinion. And the signs are all in Greek and English. It's fabulous. And they have a map and showing you all the sites that they're talking about. And I asked the guide which direction I should go first, and she was happy to. She walked me around and said, go here, go here, go here, and go here last. It was great. You could probably spend a good hour in there because there's tons of things to look at. Oh, and only €4 to get in. I decided to walk past the church again at night, and look how beautiful it is, all lit up. It's lovely. Here's another beautiful thing about Kalamata that I didn't know until I got here, is they have a beach that's 4 kilometers long. So it's a great place to come if you want to have like a beach city vacation. Like, you can do both. So it's super beautiful here in the summer. The weather has been a little bit iffy, but that's just because this year in general in Greece, the weather has been a little bit iffy, but there are actually people out here swimming and it's starting to feel warm now. It's really great. We are now at the costume collection here in Kalamata. It's a very long name. I will put a link to their website because it's too long for me to say, but it looks like it's going to be amazing. And everywhere it says it's the best museum and the best thing to do here. So very excited. This museum is actually amazing and probably one of the nicest ones I've ever seen in Greece, not just because the costumes are amazing, but the display is out of this world. Especially as a museum person, I think it's fabulous. The movement, the interactivity, definitely a must-see. All right, I'm now at the Kalamata Castle, which looks like it's going to be pretty amazing. In really good shape. Look at the walls. There is a great view of the town up here. Look at this. While this is on a bunch of lists, it's not talked about that much. I think it's a must-see. You get a whole view of the city, you get a view of the mountains, and of a castle. This is spectacular. All right, this is really something very different. A lot of times you come to a Greek castle and it's fortress after fortress and everything, but this is just flat. And I think there's a church over there. So let's go take a look. Unfortunately, the church is locked, but there's a very interesting cave over there we can go check out. I'm not gonna go down in it because the stairs are really filthy with stuff and I'm afraid I might slip and fall. I really wish I knew what this was though. Someone posted about this restaurant, Cardamo, in the conference Facebook page, and it was amazing. I had like gourmet zucchini balls and probably the best imam I've ever had. My last full day here in Kalamata, and while I'm still at the conference, I wanted to show you guys my fabulous, fabulous hotel. It's down on the beach, so it's a little bit out of the city center, but it's super easy to get in. It takes like 5 minutes. But if you want a place for luxury and relaxation, this is the place. It's called the Horizon Blue. I'm gonna show you my room and then I'm gonna go outside and show you the stunning pool area. You enter and here is the bathroom. It's a little messy because my things are in here, but what I really love is we have a bathtub, but also a separate shower stall, and the short person really appreciates that. Here is the entryway, has two closets, so if you're coming with two people, you have plenty of space. Here is the amazing bed, which is very comfortable, I might add. And then you have a little sofa area, and then the best part is this balcony area. So you have a beautiful view of the mountain, which is a little bit clouded because it's been very humid off and on. And then you have a view of the sea and it's breathtaking because you can feel the breeze. I love it. And I have found that this has been very peaceful and the service has been outstanding. What I love is that when you walk outside your room, you're outside. So it has this beautiful natural feeling, which I love. So you can get to the pool area a couple of ways. You can go out this direction from my room and go to the pool area. You can go down some stairs. There's also a pool bar restaurant. I'm not gonna go that way this time though, because I wanna take you through the inside and show you the pool area from that. This is what I mean by open air. So this is the walkway to the stairs and the elevator. And you can see they have all these beautiful planting areas. And you're gonna see that down by the pool, it's almost like being in a botanical garden. This is the lobby area. So there's a little coffee bar, and if you go that way, there's a restaurant where breakfast is served. But let's go outside, because this is the best part. So this is what I mean. It's like a botanical garden. So they have all these beautiful trees and flowers, and it smells amazing. Over there is the restaurant where breakfast is served. Breakfast has been amazing, and even though it's been cloudy, it's still really beautiful. And as you can see, the pool is stunning. So you have this beautiful pool, and then you have all these water features. We are now at this amazing restaurant with an amazing view. It's called Kastraki, obviously castle. And it's sort of up in the hills above Kalamata. So the view should be amazing. Too bad it's super cloudy, because there may not be much of a sunset as a result. This is gonna be it from Kalamata, but don't worry, I still have more content coming from the Peloponnese, so definitely subscribe if you wanna see all of that. Thanks so much for watching, guys, and I'll see you in the next video.